Today, our topic of discussion is ABC transport. ABC transport, unlike active transport, uses only ATP in the form of energy. On the other hand, active transport uses both ATP and proton motive force to translocate a substance across membrane against a concentration gradient. The full form of ABC transport is ATP binding cassettes. As the name suggests, it uses ATP, and this is the structure of biological membrane. They possess two transferment domain and two sites where ATP can bind. So these two regions are actually ATP binding sites, and that is why they are known as ABC transport. Initially, ABC transport was discovered from a human disease like cancer. Cancers are multi-drug resistant cells. So when we use drug to kill cancer cell, what happens? The cancer cell initially take drug inside it, but because of having ABC transporter on the membrane, those cancer cell can simply expel out those drug from the cell, and that is why they can survive and becomes ultimately multi-drug resistant cell. Both eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic and prokaryotic cell, do have ABC transport, but there is a significant difference. Number one is that in case of eukaryotic cell, two domains are not there. This is known as the transmembrane domain, transmembrane domain, and this is the ATP binding domain already mentioned. In case of eukaryotic cell, only one domain is present. Only one domain is present. But in case of prokaryotic cell, both transmembrane domain and ATP binding domain is there. And number two, in case of eukaryotic cell, these ABC transport is normally used to expel out certain compounds like drugs. But in case of prokaryotic cell takes up nutrient etc. into cell from environment. So ultimately there are two important differences. What you can see, in case of eukaryotic domain, there is a structural difference. Only one domain is there. In case of prokaryotic cell, both domain is present. And number two, eukaryotic cell expels certain compound like drugs by the help of ABC transport, whereas the prokaryotic cell do just the opposite thing. It takes up nutrient from outside into the cell. Now we have to the detailed mechanism of the ABC transporter. So this structure of ABC transporter actually present in two forms. One is, this is the called open form, another is can be said as a closed form. Now when it is present in open form, suppose this is the signaling molecule, this is the signal molecule. This signal molecule can come and bind to that transmembrane site here or there, any places. Upon binding the signal molecule, what will happen? Two molecules of ATP can join this ATP binding domain. So first, signaling molecule can bind here or there, and then ATP molecule, after binding of the signal molecule, ATP molecule can also join to the ATP binding domain. This ATP binding causes a conformational change in the molecule. As a result, this ATP binding site closes. Therefore, the structure becomes, this is the membrane, looks like. Now the transmembrane portion, looks somewhat like that, but the ATP portion now closes that site. So this is the signal molecule, this is the signal molecule, and this is the ATP molecule. This is the signals, and this is the continuation of the biological molecule. What will happen? The closing of this site causes the opening of that end, so that the signal molecule can be, so that the signal molecule or the molecule to be transmitted out of the cell can be ejected out. That means the closing of this transmembrane domain causing the opening of the, sorry, the closing of the ATP binding domain causes the opening of the transmembrane domain. Opening of the transmembrane domain looks like, so that ultimately the structure becomes like that. So that this signal molecule now can easily be coming out. So what you can see, the binding of ATP assists the removal of the signal molecule from the cell. But the structure must be converted to the original conformation like that. And that is why it requires the hydrolysis of ATP. So there is a small difference between normal, what you can say, in case of ATP pump like active transport, and in this case it is about ABC transport. In case of sodium potassium pump, for example, what you can see, the hydrolysis of ATP governs the conformational change in the receptor structure. But in this case, the binding of ATP actually causes the removal of the signal molecule, and to change its conformation so that it can be converted back to the original form, hydrolysis of ATP next year. So this is simply the on-off mechanism. First, the signal molecule come, bind to the transmembrane domain. Then the two molecules of ATP can combine with the two sites. After that, a conformational changes do happen, so that these two sites gets closed apart. In that case, the signal molecule can ejected out. Finally, to return to the original conformation, ATP, hydrolysis of ATP do takes place.